Some people might think that the acceptance of June the 3rd plan was a mistake on the part of the Muslim League. I would like to tell them that the consequences of any other alternative would have been too disastrous to imagine. The systematic massacre of defenseless and innocent people put to shame even the most heinous atrocities committed by the worst tyrant known to history. We thank Providence for giving us courage and faith to fight these forces of evil. If we take our inspiration and guidance from the Holy Quran, the final victory, I once again say, will be ours. Do not for a moment imagine that your enemies can ever succeed in their design. But at the same time, do not make life of the situation very grave and dangerous situation which is facing you. Do not be overwhelmed by the enormity of the dark. You are made of sterling material and are second to none. Why should you also not succeed like many others, like our own forefathers? You are a nation whose history is replete with people of wonderful grace, character and heroism. Live up to your tradition and add to another chapter of glory. All I require of you now is that every one of us whom this message reaches must bow to himself and be prepared that we might be all reflections of it. Building up Pakistan as a bulwark of Islam and as one of the greatest nations whose ideal is peace within and peace without.
Pakistan!
Keep up your morale. Do not be afraid of death. Our religion teaches us to be always prepared for death. We face it bravely. Save the honor of Pakistan and Islam. There is no better salvation for a Muslim than the death of a martyr for a righteous cause. If we are right, we cannot fail. And we shall live and not die. Do your duty and have faith in God. There is no power on earth that can undo Pakistan.
Pakistan!
Pakistan! Pakistan!